Alright guys, how you doing? It's Rabir. Hope you're all well. So this video is brought to you in association with the dudes at Origin Effect. Now, I've done videos with those guys before. Absolutely love their Revival Drive Compact, which I've used on a bunch of stuff. I have it on my board and I've used it on different recordings and things like that. I've also done their Revival Drive Hot Rod Edition, which was awesome, kind of JCM 800 fiery kind of tones. But today we're looking at something a little different actually, a little simpler to use and definitely vibey and inspiring. So let's take a look. So today we're looking at the Magma 57, which is a brand new pedal from Origin Effects based on Magnatone amplifiers from the 1950s. Some of you guys may have heard of them, may have played through some of them. I've never had the chance to play a Magnatone amplifier, but they are essentially, think like a kind of Fender Tweedy kind of sound, but they have modulation in them, so you can use them with kind of vibrato, just sort of classic 1950s kind of tones, if you can imagine that. Well, the Magma 57 is based on that kind of sound, with a couple of sort of more modern and different tweaks to make it a little bit more fun as a pedal. So you should be able to see some close-ups. It's a wonderful looking pedal made in the UK, hand-built, made from complete solid metal. It's super weighty, so it's a drive and amp vibrato in one box. Really easy to use, but it features some of the nice tweakable options that you get with things like the Revival Drive Compact and so on and so forth. So looking at the pedal from top to bottom, you've got the output, the tone and the drive along the top, and that is all the controls you have for the kind of drive kind of sound. Then in the middle you've got the vibrato, so this is the kind of special part of the pedal. So on the left you've got the intensity knob, and then you've got blend, which we'll get into a second, on the toggle switch, and then on the right you've got speed, and then a toggle switch to change how fast the speed is, so you've got quite a big range to choose from there. Going back to the intensity side of the vibrato, you can see we've got a three-way toggle for blend. It basically refers to the phase of that vibrato, so you can go between 0 degrees, have it off in the middle, and then 180 degrees. Just to give you a quick bit of wording on what that means, essentially 0 degrees means wet and dry signals are combined in phase, creating a phase cancelling effect similar to the chorus mode on the classic Univibe. And then in the off position, the blend switch delivers pure pitch vibrato like the Magnatone amps. And then 180 degrees in the down position means wet and dry signals are combined out of phase, creating a unique chorus effect. So what's cool about that is you've essentially got loads of different ways to blend this vibrato, and it does sound really cool. And then you've got the speed control, so we'll mess around with all of that as we go through this video. Then beneath that we've got the ProStrive EQ, which is super handy. We use that on the Revival Drive Compact, which is essentially, if you're running a dark amp or a bright amp or just a preamp section, you can use the little toggle switch on the left to get the right kind of brightness spectrum for your tone. And then on the right hand side you've got further adjustment, which kind of, if you need to get a little more low-end thump out of your sound, you just sort of dial it over to the right. It takes some of the high-end away. It's really useful to have in front of your amp to dial it in even further. So I love those features from the Revival Drive that they've included here. On top of the fact, it's, you know, a simple, easy-to-use pedal. Then on the bottom, we've got an on-off for the vibe and then an on-off for the pedal altogether, and the dual LED in the middle, when it's flashing orange, as you can see now, that is for the speed of the vibrato, and as I turn it up, you can see it gets faster and faster. So super handy there. If you don't want to use the vibe, you turn it off, LED goes red to say we're just using the drive section, and of course, we turn it off, it's all gone. So for this video, I figured the best way to go about showing you what this thing does is just to do a load of playing. So the rig I'm setting up today is my Fender Strat. Got the Soldano SLO-100 on a clean, running into the aux box. We've got this Magma 57 sat nicely in front there. So we're mainly going to be using this, and I'm going to be using it for all the drive. The Soldano is just acting as a clean pedal platform, and any reverb and delay you hear is coming from the aux box. So without further ado, let's check out the Magma 57 from Origin Effect. Alright, so let's start by going through the drive on the Magma 57, but first I'll show you the clean of the Soldano, bit of reverb from aux. Okay, so that's how the Strat sounds. So first thing we're going to do is just turn on the pedal. As you can see, red LED means we're just using the drive, so this is how it sounds. Just to say, I've already tweaked the post-drive EQ to fit with my amp, so this is what I'm wanting it to sound like when I turn the pedal on. Okay, As you can hear, it's taking a bit of chime out, but that's what I want. So first thing I'm going to do is back off some of the gain and boost the treble, the overall volume. Sounds great. So it's a great platform to just get your guitar, you know, being able to tune the sound of your amp and your guitar a bit more. That's just a really nice sort of responsive clean. But if we start driving it a bit, I'm just going to take the overall volume down. Sounds great. It's not super high gain, of course. It's not even close, but it's not about that. You know, it's got a nice amount of breakup. Bridge pickup. It's really clear, glassy, responsive. I have to say, this pedal in front of that with this sounds really nice, and that's not even going near the vibrato yet. That's where we start to get really more sort of vibey, atmospheric kind of vibes. But as a pedal, just straight in, even, you know, as you can see, I'm running the drive high, but it's got a really nice sound to it. And I'll just show you really quickly what happens with the EQ switch. This is EQ1. Preamp, as you can hear. So all right then, let's move on to the vibrato, but first thing I'm going to do is just take a bit of this gain down, just get a nice tone. That sounds nice. So, let's engage the vibrato. Now, obviously, intensity is all the way down, so you won't hear it. I'm going to have it in off position, so we're not having any phase happening yet to get anything weird. This is just straight up pitch vibrato. Keep the speed low. Now, as I said before, I'm just going to get into tones, really, and just do a load of playing. But just so you know, with the speed, I'll be just jumping between sort of the differences between X1, X2, and X3, which is 1, 2, and 3 times the speed. So we've got lots of range to play with. Outside of that, just going to be dialing in different vibrato and gainy kind of sounds. So let's see what happens. Just keep the speed lowish, and then bring in this pitch vibrato. So the first thing I'm going to say is the quality of the pedal, the sound of it, like the sound of the drive and even this vibrato, like straight away, it's such high quality, which is what you'd expect, because obviously this pedal is not cheap, but it really does sound beautiful. No matter where I start, you know, placing the controls, it's such a well-voiced sounding pedal. So this is a really pleasurable demo, as I'm sure you can imagine. But yeah, anyway, let's mess around with the blend control. So let me jump between 0 degrees phase and then 180 degrees, which is flipping the phase. So. So to me, they're totally right in saying that it's a classic Univibe kind of sound. It really does sound exactly the same. Really nice. I do like having the drive quite high because it starts to sort of do this cool wavy oscillation thing. And it creates a really nice effect when that drive's happening, so I'm into that. Anyway, so let me show you what happens when we flip the phase. My assumption is going to be that we'll lose quite a bit of low end compared to this. Because the idea of flipping the phase normally means that you're either having low end or not, so. Definitely good for that kind of grungy, like, mid-90s thing. So if you wanted to sort of, I mean, it sounds absolutely awesome, especially gets that kind of vibe going for me, but if you want to get more low end out of this from here, because you're losing it with flipping the phase, you could just hit the EQ switch. Which is adding back that low end, which you would normally have if you threw over to 0 degrees and put it back to, well, where I've had it, EQ2. Just take a bit of that out there. So yeah, you put it 180 degrees, EQ1. Okay then, well there's a look at the Origin FX Magma 57. Well, the first thing I'd say, aside from loving the simplicity of this pedal, is it really sounds great. The drive isn't, you know, it's not an overdrive, like serious overdrive. It's just that tasty kind of dynamic when you play with a Strat. It gives a really nice, clean, high headroom, and then you push it, you dial it up, and then it gets crunchy, but it's not like a gain stage. It's more just like an overdriven clean amp that's really barking, and I love that. The post-drive EQ is so handy on this pedal and on all their other ones, so I love that they've included that. And the vibrato itself, having the blend modes where you can flip the phase, The speed is obviously great, having a nice range, but the different blend modes is what make it, because you can get some really cool sounds. Some of that kind of chilling Opeth kind of vibe stuff, then more traditional stuff, and I'm sure people that are demoing this pedal as well are going to give you more of the traditional tones, but I wanted to give it my own spin, the way I would use this effect anyway, so maybe it's not true to the original Magnetone way of playing, but in this video I just enjoyed getting a bit vibey with it, no pun intended. But yeah, anyway, sorry about the noise, people are building next door. That's the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much to Origin Effects for sending this pedal over to me. If you want to check out more about it, I'll put it all in the description box below, but let me know what you think in the comments. Like, subscribe and share. I've been Rabir, and I will see you all very soon.